Megan Gustafson has become a fixture in the Iowa women's basketball program for 4 years. Highlighting her long list of accolades, she was named the 2019 Big Ten Player of the Year. She ended the regular season ranked in the top five nationally in 8 statistical categories. Basketball was her destiny, as both her parents played hoops in college. And in this feature, Lisa Byington helps us journey back to where Megan's earliest basketball roots began in her small hometown in Wisconsin.
Fort Wayne's just a little lake town village. You run on the south shore of Lake Superior, and it's a little hidden gem for sure.
There's no movie theater here. There's no bowling alley. You know, we have one gas station store, and we have a bank and a post office. That's about it.
Yes, I won the last game.
What makes it great is the community. I mean, the people love sports, and they love their little tiny high school, and, you know, they just support every single day. I had a graduating class of 11 kids. There was never any tryouts or anything like that. You know, if you wanted to play basketball and you were breathing, I mean, and you wanted to join, you would be on the team, and you'd be contributing. You know, everyone's included, and everyone feels important, and that's what I love about Fort Wayne.
Fort Wayne, Wisconsin, a population of just 164. For Megan Gustafson, the 2019 Big Ten Player of the Year, this is home and where her love of the game was nurtured.
Basketball was a huge part of my life, you know, growing up. Both my parents played college ball.
She has an older sister, Emily, who is 2 years older, and she started out probably in the second and third grade, and so Megan just followed along. She was real talented right from the beginning and really fell in love with it real early.
She got to play in the fifth grade game as a second grader, and she is just this little tot running around.
She ran down the court and put her arms up a little bit, and someone threw her the ball. It bounced, if I remember right, and she slapped it with her hands and turned around and threw it up, and it went right in.
After that first basket, then all of a sudden she started posting up, putting a hand up, and getting out there, just jumping up and down to get the ball. And I thought, oh yeah, she got a taste of it now. So we're going to go places.
Go places she did. From the moment she took the court for South Shore High School, Gustafson rekindled memories of a Fort Wayne legend who found success in the Big Ten.
Megan, Emily, Eva, and myself went down to the Wisconsin Badgers game to watch Jolene Anderson play, who was a star at the University of Wisconsin. Amazing. And a trailblazer for our region, just to put that idea in our minds that, you know, a girl from South Shore could go down at the college level and play and be successful.
Gustafson finished her high school career as the state's all-time leading scorer, surpassing Jolene Anderson's record and attracting attention from several Big Ten schools.
Right off the bat, I think every school that recruited the Gustafsons, you began to really hope you got them for much bigger reasons than basketball.
I think what originally drew me in was the people, especially the coaches. They have been amazing, down-to-earth people who really care about you.
Hey, player of the year! Surprise! Like you didn't know!
You get choked up thinking about it. She's just really rare, you know, and I know a lot of times people talk about those great players, you know, the rare air, and boy, she breathes it.
What a remarkable career, what a remarkable young woman.
The nation's leading scorer this season, Iowa's all-time leading scorer, Megan Gustafson, the small town girl, has left a big imprint on the Iowa basketball program and a legacy for young girls growing up in small towns with big basketball dreams.
My legacy would be all about being a role model for those kids who maybe think they come from a background where they don't have many opportunities, but they can do it. They can accomplish anything they want.